So what do you mean by a quadratic equation? You can simply say a second degree equation, an equation whose highest power of the variable is 2. And here in this chapter, in 10th standard, we'll discuss simply quadratic equation means it will be one variable. There are quadratic equation with two variables, so we don't discuss in 10th standard. We studied linear equation. Why linear equation means it will contain only a variable with the power 1. Okay, and linear equations in two variables we studied separate, right? And to, this year also, linear equations in two variables. And similarly, quadratic equation in one variable other means an equation with the highest power of the variable 2, that is second degree equations. And there will be only one variable because now we will discuss only quadratic equation with the one variable in 10th standard. Okay. So how will be the general form of LN quadratic equation with one variable? General form, first day will be that AX square plus AX square plus BX plus C equal to zero. C equal to zero. Okay. This will be the general form of a quadratic equation with in variable X. Here A, B, and C are coefficients and X is variable. Okay. So here next is what is solution of this quadratic equation? What is solution of this quadratic equation? What does that mean? Solution means
zero.
Yeah. In some other terms, we can say the zeros in the polynomial P of X is equal to AX square plus BX plus C. The zero of this polynomial AX square plus BX plus C, the quadratic polynomial, and the solutions of this equation AX square plus BX plus C are same. A solution means for what value of X the equation is satisfied. So what value of X we want to give to get this LHS and RHS equal? That means this the zero of this polynomial. Zero of the polynomial means for what value of X the polynomial P of X gives the value zero. And if this equating to zero, that means the equation will come. Okay. So the solution of this quadratic equation means for what value of X the equation satisfies, that is equal to zero. Okay. And there are some other term, the solution of a quadratic equation or solution of an equation is also called as roots. So the question may be like this. Sometimes the question may be find the solution of this quadratic given quadratic equation using factorization or some other method. Otherwise the question may be find the roots. Roots means same as what? Solutions. Roots and solutions are same. And in the case of polynomial, we'll call them as zeros. Zeros. Okay. So next we can look how to solve a quadratic equation. So there are three methods explaining test two. First method is by factorization. We already studied, we'll look at only one example, very simple. We also discussed in the polynomial chapter. And also in the 9th standard, you have studied this method to factorize a given polynomial. In 9th standard, you can see in chapter polynomials in 9th standard, you can see factorizing a polynomial, given polynomial, by splitting the middle term. Same idea here. That was the first method you studied. For example, suppose 6x square, 6x square plus 17x plus 5 is equal to 0. It's equal to 0. Equation is like this. We want to find the roots of this quadratic equation. You want to solve this. So by splitting the middle term, we can write this given equation, this LHS as product of two linear equations. So how we can split this 17x? What was the idea?
15x plus 2x.
Yes, 15x plus 2x. This 17x you can split into 15x plus 2x. So 6x square same here. And 17x you can split into 15x plus 2x. Then finally plus 5, okay, is equal to 0. So you look 15x plus 2x is simply 17x. So there's no change. But by splitting this, the idea is 15 into 2. What is 15 into 2? That is same as 15 into 2 is same as 6 into 5. In such a way, you want to split the middle term. When negative number comes, you want to be very careful. Okay. Then what's the advantage of splitting like this? In next step, how you can write?
Take common.
Take common numbers outside. Okay, so from the first two terms, what we can take outside? 3x
common. 3x
common. Okay, 3x can be taken common outside from first two terms. What will be inside?
2x plus 5.
2x plus 5 will be inside the bracket. And here plus 2x plus 5 also there. Okay, so here in these two terms, you can take 2x plus 5 outside the bracket, right? Okay. In these two terms, we can take 2x plus 5 outside the bracket. So what will come inside the bracket? 3x
plus 1.
1 will be inside the bracket and outside 2x plus 5. Okay. So like this, you can split. Now you look, 2 product is equal to 0. So definitely, at least one of them must be 0, right? For this product to be 0, one of the terms should be 0. So two chance, either 3x plus 1 is equal to 0 or 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. So from solving this, we will get the solution. So I don't go for the final solution, but anyway, you know how to solve this linear equation. So this method, the factorization method, we will split the middle term. Okay, such that the product of two splitted terms should be equal to the first x square term, the product of x square term and the constant term. In such a way we will split, then we can make the given quadratic equation as the product of two linear polynomials, 3x plus 1 into 2x plus 5, that is equal to 0. Then by equating the linear equations to be 0, you can find out the value of the variable or the solution of the quadratic equation. This was the factorization method. So next method, we'll discuss next method. I think no need more examples here because you already studied 9th standard in polynomial chapter, a factorization method. Okay.